Welcome back, road warriors and rubber enthusiasts. Lals here, diving deep into the world of tire manufacturing. Today, we're peeling back the rubber to reveal the fascinating facts and processes behind your car tires. So, let's get rolling. What's the difference between cruising the highways with confidence or skidding off course? The answer is the humble tire. But, as we're about to discover, a tire is not simply a piece of rubber. It's an incredibly sophisticated safety device, carefully designed and assembled to provide stability, traction, and comfort. Did you know that more than 50% of a tire's composition is rubber, both synthetic and natural? The rest is a blend of reinforcing materials, such as steel and fabric, along with other compounds that enhance performance and longevity. Step 1. The essential elements. Every journey has a starting point. For tires, that beginning takes the form of raw materials. Natural rubber, synthetic rubber, fabric, and steel. Natural rubber is an essential ingredient, prized for its elasticity and resistance to cold temperatures. Synthetic rubber, on the other hand, is more resistant to heat and aging. These rubbers are first prepped using processes like mastication and mixing with various accelerators and curatives. This improves the mechanical properties of the rubber, making it more durable and easy to work with. Fun fact, the fabric and steel used in tires are there to provide strength and rigidity, with the fabric often being a combination of polyester, rayon, or nylon. Step 2. Blending the recipe. Once prepared, the rubber takes a spin in the Banbury mixer, a device that feels straight out of a mad scientist's lab. Inside this apparatus, the rubber gets combined with fillers like carbon black and silica. Carbon black is a sooty material that, when added to the rubber, significantly increases the tire's durability and road wear abrasion resistance. It's also what gives your tires their black color. But that's not all. The mixer also adds various protective agents to prevent the rubber from breaking down when exposed to ozone and UV light. The result is a resilient and pliable compound that's ready to take shape. Step 3. The backbone of the tire. With our compound ready, it's time to shape the tire's key components. The tread, the sidewalls, the beads, and the plies. Each of these elements has a specific function. The tread provides grip and channels away water to prevent hydroplaning. The sidewalls connect the tread to the beads and play a significant role in handling and ride comfort. The beads are made from strong steel wires, coated in rubber, and serve to keep the tire fixed onto the rim. Lastly, the plies form the tire's internal structure, similar to the skeleton in our bodies. Made of layers of fabric coated with rubber, the plies provide strength and flexibility. Step 4. The assembly puzzle. The next step in our journey is the assembly, where the individual components come together to form the tire. A rotating drum serves as the assembly platform, with each part added in a precise order. The process begins with the ply, then the beads, followed by additional layers of ply to secure the beads. The tread and side walls are the final layers to go on. It's worth noting that some high-performance tires even include additional components like cap plies and belt plies for extra stability at high speeds. The result of this stage is the green tire and uncured tire that's starting to resemble the final product. Step 5. The curing transformation. Now, our green tire is ready to be cured, a process that gives it its final shape and properties. The green tire is placed inside a curing press, where it's subjected to high temperatures around 300 degrees Fahrenheit and pressures up to 25 tons. During this phase, the tire gets its final shape, including its tread pattern and sidewall lettering. The heat also triggers a chemical reaction known as vulcanization, where the rubber compound crosslinks, transforming from a malleable dough into a tough, elastic material that you'd recognize as a car tire. Step 6. Quality control. Emerging from the press, each tire undergoes a thorough inspection. It's here that technology and human judgment work hand in hand. Every tire is checked manually for visual defects and run through machines that use X-rays and high-powered lasers to detect any internal irregularities. This quality control ensures that all tires meet rigorous safety and performance standards. After all, these tires are the only contact between your vehicle and the road. Step 7. Road ready. Finally, before our tire is ready to hit the road, it must face one last test, the road test. A tire testing rig, it's subjected to real-world conditions, including varying speeds, loads, and temperatures. It's checked for balance, roundness, and uniformity. Some tires even get tested for specific performances like wet grip, rolling resistance, and noise levels. It's here that the tire proves it's ready for anything the open road might throw its way. There you have it, folks. The remarkable journey from raw materials to the precision-engineered car tire. It's a testament to human innovation and the relentless pursuit of safety and performance. If you've enjoyed this fascinating journey, do give us a like, share the video, and subscribe to our channel for more impressive videos and insights. See you soon. Bye. Introducing a website that unlocks access to an incredible selection of used and repossessed government cars, trucks, and SUVs, all available for purchase at up to 95% discounts. With over 4,000 government auction listings throughout the United States, this website is the perfect place to find your next vehicle. You'll have access to both live and online auctions, so you can participate in the way that suits you best. Why pay full price for your next car when you could save thousands of dollars by purchasing at a government auction? Don't miss out on this opportunity to get an amazing deal. Click the link in the attached comment to start browsing today. Thank you for watching the video to the end. Subscribe to our channel. We have a lot of interesting videos about heavy machinery and various industries, such as marble mining with the largest machines, dangerous machines working with molten metal, epic stints on the excavator, and many other videos that will be fun for you. See you soon. Bye.